Very interesting. Changing things up. Much like we've had to do all season long with all the call-ups, right?
He's going to get his chance tonight. That's all anybody can ever ask for.
We're expecting a sellout crowd. Some still trickling in. We've had four All-Star games today, pardon me, here on the Vipers floor starting very early this morning. Tip is up. It's controlled by the Vipers. We're underway. Will Conroy has the basketball. Vipers move from left to right. Offensively across your radio dial. This game televised nationally on Versus tonight. Anderson on the left wing, back up top to Will Conroy. Conroy back to the right wing to Scott, now to the corner. It goes to Stanley Asumnu. Jump stop in the lane, floater is good. Stanley Asumnu, nothing but net. Vipers off to a good start, they leave it 2-0.
Asumnu started 5 games in a row earlier this month, and he averaged about 13 points per game while a starter.
In between the circles, it's Frank Robinson. Dribbles right wing, now drives baseline. The double team comes, that's blocked by Sensley. Quick outlet to Anderson, the Vipers will run. Anderson finds Scott, right wing, jumper for 3, off the front of the rim. Rebound to Asumnu, and the Vipers have a fresh 24. Will Conroy with it between the rings. Dribbles it right side, bounce pass quickly into Sensley, stolen away by Frank Robinson. Here he comes on the break for the defenders. He takes it easily to the bucket and scores, ties the game at 2. A little too much gambling there from Will Conroy. There's Asumnu trying to get a bounce pass to Sensley in the post, and it's deflected out of bounds of Remain Vipers ball on the sideline. 19 on the shot clock, the inbound to Conroy quickly on the left wing. Conroy floats a pass into the high post. Sensley has it left of the circle, hands it off to Asumnu. Asumnu at the top of the key, retreats and resets. Now Asumnu driving it on fake, kicks it out to Conroy. 3-pointer with 5 on the shot clock is off the back of the rim. Rebound taken by Frank Robinson. Up ahead of Ryan, forehand Kelly, driving baseline, dishing off to Faye. He couldn't handle, take it away by Sensley. Long pass ahead for Conroy with an easy deuce. Vipers up 4-2.
Transition basketball, the ability to get ahead of your defenders is so huge for the Vipers because they can get a lot of buckets like that.
Right, in between the circles. Scans the floor, bounces it over to Robinson on the right wing, around the screen from Peters. Robinson pulls up for a long triple off the front of the rim. And the rebound comes out to Sensley. The Vipers will run. Conroy up ahead to Anderson. Drives it in. Jump stop in the lane. Kick it out to Scott. Bad pass, so he had to dish it off. Now to Sensley on the wing. Sensley in on Faye. Crossing over. Tried to dish it out to Asumnu, but that's deflected. Nice telegraph on that pass by Frank Robinson. And he takes it all the way to the cup, and he scores. We're tied at 4. 9:46 to go in the opening quarter.
Was that an instant replay of the other basket Robinson
scored? Looked exactly
scored?
The same, didn't it? Vipers getting a little too cute here on offense. Anderson at the top of the key. Fakes on the pass, now driving in on Peters, out to Asumnu. 7 on the shot clock. Fall away from the foul line, off the front of the rim. Tip from Conroy is no good. It comes right to Peters, and he will bring it the other way for the LA defenders. Peters, top of the key, driving it in, left side, dishes underneath for Faye. Tries to go up for a reverse. He is, just loses it out of bounds. It'll be Vipers' ball. I thought there was a foul.
I think he thought it was coming, so Faye kind of shoveled the ball upwards to try and get into the act of shooting.
So Conroy brings it the other way for Rio Grande Valley. 9:10 to go in the opening quarter. We're tied at 4. Conroy on top of the center court logo, swings it right side to Julian Sensley. Down to the post to Conroy, backing it in. Lost the handle, has to retreat to get it over on the wing. 5 remaining on the shot clock. Conroy's got to get rid of it. Dishes it off with 2 on the shot clock. Sensley lets it fly at the buzzer off the back of the rim. Anderson with the rebound, tips it over to Asumnu. Spins and fires and throws it off of the window, and he scores. I thought he was going to throw it over his head. And one of the clocks is off as LA was bringing it the other way. Now the clock started working. Someone needs to watch their feet over there by the the LA basket.
Well, the buzzer sounded too.
Oh, I think the buzzer sounded when they went off to say, hey, it went off. Nevertheless, we're back to live action here. So LA has possession with the Vipers up 6-4. Frank Robinson on the right wing. I don't believe there's any relation to the Baseball Hall of Famer. Stolen the other way. Here come the Vipers. Sensley on the layup. Misses it. The rebound comes out to the defender. Now forehand Kelly has it for LA. Now to the corner, driving it in, and scoring there is James Wright. 6'2 guard out of Colorado scores, ties the game at 6. Conroy bounces into the post to Sensley. He's got Faye on him, backing it in, dishes it off. Now to Anderson, left corner. Tries to drive it in on Peters. He'll skip it over to Scott. Now right corner, Sensley fakes on the shot. Seven on the shot clock. Sensley drives. Come on, that was a foul. Sensley wanted to call. I wanted to call. Didn't get it. And here comes L.A. the other way. Forehand Kelly finds Peters in the corner. Robinson in the corner. He drives it in. Dishes it off to Faye at the last second. And he lays it up and scores. And L.A. has their first lead. It's 8-6. Here's Conroy at the right elbow. One-handed pass over to Scott. Now to Asumnu. Asumnu driving it in, puts it up, a finger roll layup, score, a basket, and the foul. Michael Fay didn't like the call. Vipers score the basket for Asumnu. We're tied at 8. Vipers have a chance to regain the lead if we hit this 3-point play.
Well, Stanley Asumnu missed all 4 of his free throw attempts yesterday on the season. He's a 45% free throw shooter. 82 tries.
Asumnu misses off the back of the rim, but Scott tips the rebound, and Asumnu has it in the left corner. They get it to Scott, left open for 3. Bingo! Ernest Scott from downtown, 11-8.
Your standard 5-point play.
7:20 to go here in the opening quarter. Vipers take advantage of the poor free throw shooting of Stanley, but the good hustling pays off.
They've done that a few times this year, too.
Certainly have. Here's Peters. Fall away, goes bank off of the window, then comes up with the steal after he scores, and they get it to Fay at the top of the key. He misses off the back of the rim, and here come the defenders the other way. Conroy on the break, driving it in. A runner, the teardrop, it falls. Vipers have the lead 13-10. 6:48 to go in the opening quarter. Right, driving in on Conroy. Left-hand layup, score the bucket and the foul. 13-12 our score. Wright will look to tie it here as he heads for the charity stripe.
Interesting thing to note is that neither team has made a substitution yet. At this point yesterday, LA hadn't, but the Vipers had already gone to Jonathan Wallace to be their scoring punch off the bench. But with the shorter roster, with Quinn Humphrey missing the game with a groin injury, perhaps they'll wait a little longer before coming off the bench. And of course, LA's got a guy back who can be a scoring punch off the bench too. Dart Tucker's dressed tonight after missing yesterday's game with a left knee bruise.
13-13 after Wright's made free throw. Anderson has it on the left wing for Rio Grande Valley, trying to cross over Fay. It deflects off his leg out of bounds. It'll remain Vipers' ball, though there's only 7 seconds remaining on the shot clock. Crowd stickling, still trickling in here to State Farm Arena. I don't know what I was saying. Fans lighting up here in the quarter. We got a lot of the Winter Texans that are still around and haven't left yet. They're still sticking around, watching some good old Vipers basketball. They've been a big part of the Vipers fan success this season.
Absolutely. I mean, the Winter Texans have been out at pretty much every game, and they've come in buses, which is always an awe-inspiring thing to watch them just coming off.
Thanks to our friends at Gran Turismo Del Valle, Gran Turismo, dot com. Tried to get the gratuitous free plug in that's such your specialty, but I need to maybe keep it to you. Sensley hits a 3 from the top of the key. 18-15, Vipers with the lead.
Well, I got the rest of my trailer earlier, so I had an advantage.
Here's Wright on the right wing, off the back of the rim. Anderson with the rebound, quick outlet to Conroy. Conroy bounces it over to Scott, right corner, now to Conroy in the right wing. Conroy directing traffic, and a bad pass from Conroy. Robinson takes it away. Can you say deja vu? I can, only this time Frank Robinson stuffs it in with a slam dunk. It's a 1-point game. Vipers still lead by 1, but we get a timeout on the floor. We'll take one as well. 5:16 to go here in the opening quarter. Vipers lead it over the defenders, 18-17. We'll be back after this timeout. Stay with us. This is Vipers basketball, 104.9 Jack FM.